Good morning children, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. So today in this class we are going to start a new chapter, lesson number 2, Amazing Animals. Okay, so nature is versatile and it has given us a numerous kind of animals that are scattered all around the world. Okay, so all these creatures are very well adapted to their environment. Animals really are amazing creatures, is it children? So let us find out most unique and interesting fact about these amazing animals in this chapter. Okay, so now you all open your textbook, lesson number 2, Amazing Animals. Okay children, so here what they have given, write the names of the amazing animals with the help of the given clues. Okay, so shall we start? The first is, they are the largest of the apes. They live in family groups in the warm forest of Central Africa. Fruits, roots, tree barks and leaves are their food. So which is this animal? Actually, they are the largest of the apes. Okay, so what are these apes? Is a branch of old world tailless animal. Okay, so these doesn't have tails. So this is this animal, it is the largest of the apes. Okay, so it is called gorilla. The first answer is gorilla. Okay, G O R I L L A, gorilla. Okay, so they are the largest of the apes. Shall we move on to the second one? A large seabird, it spends most of its time in the air over the oceans. Among birds, it has the largest wingspan of up to 3.5 meters. It can sleep peacefully on the ocean's surface. So which is this bird? It is albatross. Okay, so the second answer is albatross. A L B A T R O S S. Albatross. Okay, so a large seabird, it spends most of its time in the air over the ocean. So these birds are mostly in Southern Ocean and the Northern Pacific. Okay, so the specialty, the unique about this bird is it has the largest wingspan of up to 3.5 meters. Okay, next we'll move on to the third one. This animal is found in Central and South America. They feed upon termites. Their back are covered with an armor of bony plates and they can roll themselves into a ball when attacked, giving them complete protection. So this animal is called as armadillo. Okay. So the third answer is armadillo. A R M A D I L L O. So what is this unique about these animals? They feed upon termites. Termites means it is an insect. Okay. So their back are covered with an armor of bony plates. So armor means it's a metal type. Okay. So their back is covered with a armor, metal type bony plates. And when they are attacked, they can roll their body into a ball. Their body is rolled into a ball to protect themselves. So this is called as armadillo. Okay. Next we'll move on to the fourth one. These are big weasel like animals found in Europe, North America and Asia. Their underground burrows are called cells. So this is badger. Okay, the fourth answer is badger. B A D G E R. So what is this? It is, these are big V-sign like animals. V-sign means it is a small mammal. So these are, and these animals, these are short legged animals. Their legs will be short. Okay. So these are big V-sign like animals found in Europe, North America and Asia. Their underground burrows are called sets. So they live in underground burrows. So these animals are called as badger. The name of this animal is badger. B-A-D-G-E-R. Badger. Okay. Next we'll move on to the fifth one. It belongs to the camel family but has no humps. They are mostly found in the Andes Mountains in South America. So you all have seen the camel, right? So camel will be having a hump on its back, is it? So this animal also belongs to the camel family, but it does not have a hump on it. Okay, there is no humps. So it is called as llama. Okay, so the fifth answer is llama. L L A M A, llama. So it is, so this animal belongs to the camel family but has no humps. They are mostly found in the Andes Mountains in the South America. Okay, so next we'll move on to the sixth question. They build a home of mud and sticks by the side of a pool, which is called a lodge. They are very good swimmers. It is beaver. The sixth answer is beaver. B-E-A-V-E-R. Beaver. So these animals build their homes of mud. Okay, build their homes of mud and sticks by the side of a pool. Okay, so these animals live by the side of the pool and they build animals by mud and sticks. So which is called as lodge. They are very good swimmers. So these animals are very good swimmers also. So it is called as beaver. B-E-A-V-E-R. Beaver. Okay. Next we'll move on to the last one. Seventh question. An extinct bird. It was found in the Mauritius island. They had no proper wings and could not fly. Its name is derived from a Portuguese word which meant simpleton. So this is dodo. It is called as dodo. D-O-D-O. Okay, so this, it is an extinct bird. We cannot find this bird in this world. It's already extinct and it was found in Mauritius Island. And this bird doesn't have any wings, proper wings, and this couldn't fly, could not fly. Its name is, this dodo, the name is derived from the Portuguese word which meant simpleton. Okay children, so these are some of the amazing animals which can be found in the world. Some are extinct also. For example, this dodo is an extinct bird. Okay children, so here like this you have to complete your textbook exercise. Okay? So children, now we have completed lesson number 2, Amazing Animals. Is it? Now, next we are moving to lesson number 3, Natural Disasters. So what is this natural disasters? A major event brought about by the natural processes of the earth that causes widespread destruction to the environment and loss of life. They are caused by the forces of nature. Okay, so these natural disasters means they are caused by the forces of nature. They cause major damages to the lives and the nature also. For example, write down example of natural disasters are floods, volcanic expression, earthquake, cyclone, wildlife. So these are some of the examples of natural disasters. So what is natural disasters? It is the major event brought about by the natural processes of the earth. Okay, so they are caused by the, they are suddenly caused by the forces of the nature. So in this lesson we are going to learn some of the natural disasters. Okay, so children, now we'll start writing the textbook exercise. Okay, lesson number 3, natural disasters. Read the clues and write the correct term for each of the following natural phenomena. Okay, so the first question is, a severe storm in which strong winds move in a circle at a speed of at least 120 km per hour. It also has an I, so it is cyclone. The first answer is cyclone. C-Y-C-L-O-N-E, cyclone. So it is caused, it is a severe storm in which strong winds move in a circle. Okay, it is a severe storm in which strong winds move in a circle at a speed of at least 120 km per hour. Okay, so it is called as cyclone. So the second one, a sudden trembling and shaking of the ground due to the movement of the earth's crust. It is earthquake. The second is earthquake. E-A-R-T-H-Q-U-A-K-E. Earthquake. So earthquake means it is a sudden trembling and shaking of the ground due to the movement of the earth's crust. Okay, due to the movement of the earth's crust, it is called as earthquake. Next, third one, an overflow of water beyond normal due to incessant rain or overflowing rivers, etc. Incessant due to the continuous rain and overflow of the rivers. Okay, overflowing rivers and overflow of water beyond normal. Okay, the beyond normal level, the overflow of water. It is flood. Okay, the third answer is flood. F-L-O-O-D. So, it is caused by the overflow of water beyond the normal. Okay. The fourth one, continuous absence of rain for a long period with rivers, wells and canals drying up. So, if there is no rain for a long period, what will happen, children? The rivers, wells, canals, all will dry up, is it? So, it is called as drought. The fourth answer is drought. D-R-O-U-G-H-T. Drought. So drought means it is the due to the continuous absence of rain. Okay, there will be no rain. If there is no rain for a long period, all the rivers, wells, canals, all will dry up, is it? So it is called as drought. Next, the fifth one, regular movement of the oceans caused by the attraction of the moon. It is called as tides. The fifth answer is tides. T-I-D-E-S. Tides. So, tides is caused by the combined. It is caused by the combined effects of the gravitational forces exerted, released by the moon and the sun and the rotation of the earth. So, it is called as tides. Okay. So, tides means it is a regular movement of the oceans caused by the attraction of the moon. Next, sixth one. A mountain or hill having an opening in the earth's crust through which lava, gases, etc. are expelled continually or at intervals. So this is called as volcano. V O L C A N O, volcano. So this volcano has happened. It is the opening of the mountain or hill having an opening in the earth's crust. Due to the pressure under the earth's crust, the volcano will come out. Okay. Next, the seventh one. They are violent, whirling windstorms occurring mostly in America, often accompanied by a funnel-shaped cloud. It is tornado. So the seventh answer is tornado. T O R N A D O. Tornado. T O R N A D O. So it is a violent whirling windstorm. Okay, often accompanied. So there will be a funnel type of cloud. Okay, there will be a funnel type of cloud accompanied by a funnel shape of cloud. It is called as tornado. T O R N A D O. Tornado. Okay. Next, the eighth one. A desert storm of wind with clouds of sand. A desert storm. Okay. Desert storm of wind with clouds of sand. It is called as sandstorm. So the eighth answer is sandstorm. S A N D S T R O M. Okay. S A N D S T, sorry, S T O R M. Storm. S T O R M. Sandstorm. So it will be in a desert storm of wind. Okay, in the desert, this storm of wind with clouds of sand. It is called as sandstorm. S A N D S T O R M. Sandstorm. Next, the last one. A long high sea wave caused by underwater earthquakes or other disturbance. It is called as tsunami. The ninth answer is tsunami. Okay. T S U N A M I. Tsunami. So this is caused by the earthquake underwater. Okay. Caused by underwater earthquake or other disturbance. A long high sea wave caused by underwater earthquake or other disturbance. So it is called as tsunami. Okay, children. So these are some of the natural disasters. Okay, write down neatly. Okay, children. So here is the time to end the session. Next session will be with the new chapter. Okay, thank you.